Hello all, I am Professor Becker. I am teaching data science in elective this semester. The prerequisite of this course is introduction about AI, machine learning, scientific method, processes, algorithm of machine learning, and some background of mathematics. So here are some course objectives. The primary objective of this course is to develop both theoretical knowledge on data skills, which can be applied to practical problems for explaining how math and information science can contribute to building better algorithms and software. To develop applied experiences with data science software, programming, application and process. So far, I have been discussing the introduction of data science. Today, the topic of discussion is big data and data science. Is it a hype? According to me, I assume no, it's not. So, denying that big data is a new paradigm post the year 2000 is like saying that human population has been huge for a long time. If we can handle 10 million human beings as we did a few thousand years ago, we can handle 10 billion today the same way, even 1 trillion. Each time a credit card is swapped or processed online, an analytical algorithm is used to detect if it is fraudulent or not, and the answer must come in less than 3 seconds most of the time with low false negative rate. Each time you do a Google search, an analytical engine determines with search result to show you which ads advertisement to display. Each time with some post, someone posts something on Facebook, an analytical algorithm is run to determine if it must be rejected, promotion, spam, porn, etc. or not. Each tweet is posted is analyzed by an analytical algorithm designed by a number of various companies to detect new viral trends, or for journalists, or disease spread, intelligence leaks, or many things, many other things. Each time you browse Amazon, the customized content delivered to you is analytically calculated to optimize Amazon's revenue. Each time an email is sent, an analytical algorithm decides whether or not to put it in your spam box. Okay, so evidently there is a gigantic amount of pre-computation and lookup tables being used to make this happen. But it still is big data analytics. The analytic engineer knows that his ad matching algorithm must use the right metrics, the right lookup tables to do a great computation, and the speed at which the results are delivered, typically measured in milliseconds. So we just can't separate the two processes, data flow and analytics or data science. Also, big data practitioners working for startups usually wear multiple hats. They are called data engineer, business scientist, machine learning, statistics, analytics engineer. So the term data scientist suits them very well. So there is no question that data science, big data has hit businesses, government and scientific sector. The demand for skills in data science is unprecedented in sectors where values, competitiveness and effectiveness are driven by data. However, there is a plenty of misleading hype around this big data and data science and one more, data analytics. But we'll discuss data science and big data today. We'll demystify this. So world's most resource, most valuable resource of centuries, no longer oil, yes, but the data. Big data are big news just about everything you go these days. According to Michael Dell in 2014, big data is a big news. Okay, big news just about everywhere you go these days. Here in Texas, everything is big, so we just call it data, according to that Michael Dell in year 2014. So what is big data? Big data is a collection of data that is huge in volume yet growing exponentially with time. It is a data with so large size and complexity that none of traditional data management tools can store it or process it efficiently. This big data is very vast. Big data is also a data but with a huge size. Okay. So, following are some big data examples. I have quoted 3 examples of big data. The New York Stock Exchange is an example of big data that generates about 1 terabyte of new trade data per day. Imagine 1 terabyte of new data per day, new trade data per day. So the next example is social media. Statistics show that 500 plus terabytes of new data gets ingested into the database of social media site Facebook every day. This data is mainly generated in terms of photos and videos upload, message exchange, putting comments, etc. So Facebook was our social media was another example of big data. And the last one is single jet. Last but not the least, single jet engine can generate 10 plus terabytes of data in 30 minutes of flight time. With many thousand flights per day, generation of data reaches up to many petabytes. So demystifying the big data hype. There is no question that big data also hit business, government, scientific sectors. Indeed, the term big data has acquired the trapping of religion. However, there are a lot of examples of companies that were into big data before they were called big data. These companies were already working on big data before the term was coined. The term coined in 1998 by two researchers at SGI. But what exactly are big data? In short, the term big data applies to information that cannot be processed or handled using traditional process or tools. Information that we cannot handle by traditional process. And big data are an architecture, and most related challenges are it. So there are four characteristics of big data, four main characteristics of big data, or we cannot define big data without these characteristics. These four V's are, big data can be described by these following four V's: volume, width, variety, velocity, variability. So volume, as the name big data itself is related to a size which is enormous. Size of data plays a very crucial role in determining value out of data. Also, whether a particular data can actually be considered as big data or not is dependent upon the volume of data. Hence, the volume is one characteristic which needs to be considered while dealing with big data solution. Variety. The next aspect of big data is variety. Variety refers to the heterogeneous source of and the nature of data. During earlier days, spreadsheets and databases were the only source of data considered by most of the applications. Okay, only spreadsheets and database. But nowadays, data in the form of emails, photos, videos, monitoring devices, PDFs, audios, etc. So velocity, third feature of this big data is velocity. The term velocity refers to the speed of generation of data. How, at what speed, at what rate the data is generated. So how fast the data is generated and processed to meet the demands determines real potential in the data. Variability means it refers to the inconsistency which can shown by data at times. Okay. So thus hampering the process of being able to handle actually the data effectively. Above is standard definitions, means the four V's of big data is vulnerable to criticism of skeptics that V's have already been there. But what's new? While big data is often large in size relative to the available tool set, big actually refers to being important. According to many scientists and engineers have long known that data is valuable, but now the rest of the world, including those in control of pure strings, understand the value that can be created from data. So demystifying the data science hype, the demand for data scientists, the magicians, data scientists are considered as the magicians for big data era, is unprecedented in the sectors where value, competitiveness and efficiency are driven by data. The Data Science Association defines in October 2013 the term data and data scientist as, again, a new definition by Data Science Association. definition of data science and data scientist as given by this Data Science Association. Data science is a scientific study of creation, validation, and transformation of data to create meaning. And data scientist is a person, is a professional who uses scientific methods to liberate and create meaning from raw data. So demystifying this hype, some people might remember in 2006 that there was no such thing as data science. People were either called data miners or experts or statisticians in intelligent systems. The projects being done were mostly on text analysis, data classification, image recognition, and robotics without the label data science. This work was being done but without the label of data science. In 2012, the word data science started appearing. Data miners did a great job at the time in the finding correlations and classifications of data. Businesses started to understand the value of data mining and machine learning could bring. Therefore, the job title data science started to become fashionable. So it's not a hype. Okay. So data science is a very interdisciplinary science, and thus we shall define it through its subfield. One of those important subfields is machine learning. Machine learning is concerned with the question of how to construct computer programs that automatically improve with experience. Machine learning is interdisciplinary in nature and employs a technique from the field of computer science, statistics, and artificial intelligence, among others. So I have demystifying the hype of data science and big data. Please watch others' video, data science, continue.